In 1 year, renewables have installed more power capacity at nuclear in the last 70 years. That is the only technology today that can be deployed in a time that is consistent with the Paris Agreement goals.
We've reached just under 4 terawatts of operational renewable energy, and one of the outcomes of COP28 was a big consensus for a tripling that number to 11 terawatts globally.
We are really committed towards these objectives. Naturgy, as you know, is a 180 years old company. Energy is our business and transformation is really our soul.
Ninguna duda de que las energías renovables son uno de los instrumentos fundamentales que hoy por hoy contamos y sin duda alguna marcarán el futuro de todas las empresas y de todos los interesados en el mundo de la energía.
So if it's good for the environment, it's good for the economy, if it's good for security, why we are not running more than we are already running?
The money is there, but what we're missing is good projects.
There is a class of investors that might be adapting, but at the end of the day, we need some sort of market redesign.
The marginal cost that usually has been used in the market to fix the price doesn't work for renewables.
And returns are falling, especially they're falling and they have fallen quite low in countries which have been the first one to embrace renewable energy. This is, you know, the winner's curse in a way.
So we need long-term contract, and we also need to enhance capacity.
Part of the problem of some of the storage solutions that exist now is the cost, because they are new technologies. I mean, I don't want to talk about the elephant in the room, which is hydrogen.
Hydrogen will be already very close to be economically viable. So the question is not the supply side, the question is the demand side.
It's all a matter of scale and location. In some places and for some sectors, they will be incredibly important. And for some locations and some other sectors, other technologies will be more important.
So everyone is talking about a transition that should be fair and inclusive. But the reality is that we are leaving someone behind us. Continent as Africa, Southeast Asia, they need a kind of reviewing the way we are supporting them.
We need a solution that relies on many different pillars and not only infrastructure. The fact that infrastructure in Africa, for instance, does not exist, I think we should see that and they should see that as an opportunity to bypass that phase, build and implement new ways of producing and distributing energy.
It's not just a question of charity, of fairness or justice. Because if we don't intercept that increase in the demand, everything will go out of control.